वी गॉट हेमंत महोदय, मोहा महोदया एंड नवीन महोदय।
सर्वेषां नमो नमः।
सर्वेषां
नमो नमः।
यू कैन ऑल हियर मी जस्ट फाइन।
आम आचार्य महोदय।
ओके, आई हैव टू जस्ट सी हू एल्स इज जॉइनिंग, इफ एनीबडी इज जॉइनिंग। ओके, सो एनीबडी, लेट्स जस्ट सी इफ एनीबडी एल्स जॉइंड। ओके, नो आई थिंक वी आर गुड, सो लेट अस स्टार्ट। फर्स्ट वी विल टुडे वील स्टार्ट विद अ ओमकार। Now, have you heard many other words with a kar at the end? Omkar, jaykar, akar, makar. Svikar is slightly different, but yes, the suffix that we are talking about, the kar. What does
it
mean?
Can we include prakar?
No. So when I explain the meaning, then you will understand why you cannot include some of the other words which coincidentally have a similar suffix.
Okay.
So does anybody want to guess why is it
so karak? Is it from the word karak? Karak tattva?
No.
No idea, sir.
It is to denote the sound of that word which it suffixes. So when you say Omkar, it means the sound of Om. When you say Jaykar, it means the sound, or you can say a shouting or a when you say Jaykar, Jay, so that loud sound, the sound of that previous word, so that is what it means. So when you hear Makar, have you heard of Makar somewhere? It's not very much used in language too much, Makar word, but it is used while teaching, or you might see it in books here and there. So even makar means the sound of ma.
Makar,
so similar to omkar and jaykar, makar means the sound of ma. So whatever kar prefix, kar suffixes, the meaning is the sound of that word or letter.
Okay.
All right, so now we will start with about a minute of Omkar today. And do you remember, does everybody remember that when you pronounce the all three properly, a, u, and or ma, the sound moves from the bottom of your, about close to your stomach, and it moves up to the Vishuddhi chakra. And I can give you the exact position. This is is the just below the navel, so you can I won't write nibble. Let us write nabhi because that is the right Sanskrit word for it.
आम आचरण धन्यवाद
नाभि which means actually let me draw a figure. I just hope it looks all right. Okay.
You are so good with your drawing. So quick.
Thank you, Madhi. Let's just assume that this is a yogi. Now it became a yogi in me. Okay, so that's her dress. Okay, so this is the navel, right? So this a sound, the initial a, goes here. So actually when you try to pronounce it, and if you close your eyes and just notice where the sound is coming from inside your body, you will definitely know that it is rising from around below your navel. And let us color this a little bit differently so that it's easier to visualize. So this is the sound.
Sarvesham namo namaha. Sorry, I'm late.
Namo namaha, Varsha Mahodaya.
It was not letting me in again.
Oh, same thing was happening, which you faced some time ago, a few weeks ago. Was it a similar thing,
yes,
or something different? Varsha?
Same thing was happening.
Okay, so Varsha ji, your voice is still slightly breaking. I hope you are able to hear me properly.
It was same. I am able to hear you properly.
Okay, now we can also hear you.
Okay.
Okay, so I was showing you that this is the place for the sound. You will definitely notice when you close your eyes. Make sure we close our eyes and we will do it together. So you will notice that the sound comes from here. All right, now let us try it, just the sound. We will do it two times. I will make the sound, and when I stop, then you try it on your own. Depending on your breath, you can extend how much you want to make the sound. All right, so let's do it twice. 1, 2, 3. I don't seem to hear you for too long. So either you are making a very short sound or there is an internet problem. So please try to make it at least 5 seconds or more. Mine goes for 15-20 seconds sometimes. But you don't have to worry about the length right now. Whatever you can do, with your exhaling breath, exhalation breath, and you can breathe in enough before you try. Okay, one last time. Close your eyes. Do you feel it here? And you will also notice that it rises from there and vibrates your whole body. So it goes up from there. All right. Now let's choose another color for the next one. When we say woo, it comes from our Anahata chakra. So this is the woo area, the Anahata chakra. Which is the Hridayam. Alright, so let me write that here as well. So somewhere in the middle of your chest, you will feel the sound. Let's try it three times at once. All right. The last one you can say with me, but first two, just say after I'm done with my woo, then you start with your woo. And make sure you close your eyes and feel the vibration. You don't have to worry too much about focusing, but just sense where the woo is coming from within your sharir, and you will notice it is around that area which I just showed in the picture here. All right. Do you notice it here?
In the chest.
In your chest, middle of your chest. That is the Anahat chakra area. And finally, the would come from your Vishuddhi. And for this yogi or yogini, the neck is drawn really short, but Vishuddhi is in the neck, right? So that is where the M sound comes from. And you might see a difference in my writing, because for Vishuddhi I am actually writing the chakra name, but for Hriday I didn't write the chakra name. We can actually write, but because we have the organ name also, It's just three different types that I wrote. All right, so let's do the m now, just the m. All right, and after this we will try the whole aum. And when you do the aum, make sure we take the three sounds a, u, and m, all three about equal timing. So whether you make it for 2 seconds each or 3 seconds each or 4 seconds each, depending on your length of your breath, the exhalation breath, keep the timing same. Try to keep the timing similar as much as possible. So you can measure your breath. If you know your exhalation takes about 10 seconds, for example, so then just spend 3 seconds on each. All right, so we will do that later. Let's do the first. Again, three times. Notice in your body, where does it vibrate? Close your eyes. I'll start. All right, now let's try the full aum. We'll do it twice and then we will proceed. So I'll start and then you can follow after I'm done with my aum. All right, each time. We did it twice. This time I want you to notice how the sound moves inside the body. You will definitely notice that from the bottom of your navel, it moves towards your upper body. All right, one last time. Close your eyes. Do you sense the moving sound? And some of you, if you have done Shambhavi Mahamudra, and I know that some of you already know it, then you might be doing this every day. So that's even better. But doing this aum properly, even once or twice in a day, helps a lot. It helps regulate your internal energies of the body. So even if you are not doing Shambhavi and you are doing something else, like Isha Kriya, which is freely available on the net, you can definitely combine it with this Aum Uchcharan. Extremely useful, extremely beneficial. All right, so now where, let me change the color. Yes. Okay, so now we will see it's few variety of things today. It's not only spoken Sanskrit today like we do every time. We will do that as well, but there are few additional things, slight change in variety. All right, so first thing is we will do a little Parichayah. So now a proper Parichayah. Till today we have been learning Mama Naam Anshu, Mama Naam Moha, like telling your name. However, when you properly introduce yourself, then what you would say, and let me write one example here, and then you would Mama Naam Anshu, Aham Shikshakah. All right, so now that is a slightly better introduction. You are telling your name and then what do you do? Just that. All right, so I will ask that question to one of you and then you can start passing it on, similar to the way I did. All right, Mama Naam Anshu, Aham Shikshakah. भवतः कः हेमंत महोदय?
मम नाम हेमंत, अहम सॉफ्टवेयर इंजीनियर. व्हाट डू यू से सॉफ्टवेयर इंजीनियर इन संस्कृत?
फॉर सॉफ्टवेयर वी हैव टू, इफ समबडी नोज द वर्ड प्लीज टेल मी, आई डोंट रिमेम्बर राइट नाउ. फॉर सॉफ्टवेयर एट लीस्ट.
फॉर इंजीनियर, फॉर इंजीनियर इट्स
अभियंता.
Abhiyanta,
ha, ha. So engineer, we know it is Abhiyanta. So that is a good thing that we are discovering a new word. Thanks. Thank you, Amanji. And software and hardware, please take that as your Griha Karya. Or if you want to work together today itself, we can do that as well, because it needs discussion. And right after this, we will also review our last week's Griha Karya, which was recorded. All right, Hemant ji, say it again.
Mam naam Hemant, aham abhiyanta.
Abhiyanta. So abhiyanta ends in a dirghata. So you don't have to add the visarga there, because visarga will make it plural, which you don't want.
Okay. Mam naam Hemant, aham abhiyanta. Naveen Mahodaya. Mahodaya. Mahodaya.
Hemant Mahode, once more, you have to ask. Or you can ask very simple, the same question that we have been using earlier. You can simply ask Bhavatah Naam Kim, and he will add his own information that is allowed to him, right? So just ask Hemant ji.
Naveen Mahode, Bhavatah Naam Kim.
Once more, Hemant ji.
Bhavatah Naam Kim, Naveen Mahodaya.
Naveen Mahodaya, yes.
नमस्ते हेमंत महोदय, मम नाम नवीनः, अहम् अभियन्ता अभियन्ता अहम् अभियन्ता कार्यं करोमि. Are you able to hear me?
Yeah, you said aham abhiyanta and then it broke up little bit.
I said aham abhiyanta karyam karomi.
Karyam karomi. Uttamam, uttamam. Prichadu.
वर्ष महोदय, भवत्याः नाम किम्? भवत्याः किं कार्यं करोसि?
मम नाम वर्षा, अहं छात्रा.
उत्तमम्.
Chhatra student, right?
Yeah. Matlab female student is chhatra. Chhatra is female.
If you wanted to say that you are a male, then he would say chhatra. You are chhatra. So that is go ahead, Varshaji.
Okay. भवतः किं भवत्याः का मोहजि?
मम नाम मोहा, अहं लेखिका च अवुड से आंतरप्रूनर आचार्य महोदय.
आंतरप्रूनर.
आई डोंट वांट टू यूज यस इट्स आंतरप्रूनरशिप सो
आंतरप्रूनर. आई थिंक लेट अस ऐड दैट टू आवर गृह कार्य आल्सो.
मम लेखिका,
अहं लेखिका.
Okay, if it is business woman then?
Huh, but for entrepreneur, you can always use the word the vyapari, because it is related to business, right? So you are essentially saying you are a business woman. So, aham vyapari shikshika or lekhika vyapari cha, that will also do for now. किं व्यापार करोसि मोहा महोदय?
इंटरेस्टिंग.
सी आई एम जस्ट गिविंग यू फ्रीडम टू ट्राई टू टॉक. यू कैन सी इफ यू इट्स पॉसिबल. एंड दैट वे वी डिस्कवर न्यू वर्ड्स.
Too difficult actually. I'm not able to frame anything. Shit.
Is it related to textile or is it related to
Imprechnam?
I think I remember it is probably something with cloths, right?
Anything. Because yeah, Navinji, as we're saying, I'm a designer, Navinji. I work with artisans and into organic dyes and handlooms. So it's too huge a sentence to form anything actually.
Let us add all that to our Grah Karya.
Handloom is Hathkarga.
Hathkarga, correct. Or Grah Udyog.
Don't Hindi word?
हाँ तो हथ का हस्त हो जाएगा हस्त करगा हाँ ये वर्ड है हस्त करगा तो है
सो हस्त करगा डू यू नो फॉर श्योर करगा इज सेम इन संस्कृत बिकॉज़ आई डू नॉट वांट टू से एनीथिंग येट इफ आई
बिकॉज़ इवन व्यापार इज द राइट वर्ड इज व्हाट आई वाज एक्चुअली वंडरिंग एट दैट मोमेंट Or is it something else? Kray, vikray is something different, but
Vanik.
Vanik.
So it would be Vanika. Vanik, Vanik. Vanika.
Vanika or Vanika is Vyapari or business
and if we want to add self because entrepreneur is someone who so, has their own business so we can add
your voice Swayat is breaking sometimes Varsha ji
Vanika maybe saying we can say Swayat Vanika
I really want to appreciate you, Varshaji, so much. You always come with so much of preparation to the class.
Because she is a Chhatra, right? So she has to.
Yeah. She actually comes here.
Yeah.
She has a lot of
No.
And she is good with the internet also, probably. While attending the class, looking here and there is also possible, right? So even that can help.
But she has been very consistent.
But yeah, thank you. Dhanyavad Varsha ji. So Ayat Vanika.
I'm just adding Hindi words and it is working.
Yeah, it does because even see Grah Karya we use commonly in Hindi also. And Grah Karyam in Sanskrit also it's the same word because it is based on a Sanskrit word. So it's the same thing.
हाँ वो तत्सम और तद्भव पता हो तो वो हो जाता है सिंपल एक वर्ड निकालो उसका वो कर लो चेंज तत्सम तद्भव
यस
संस्कृत में जाता है
Yes, and we will come to that a little later. Now, does anybody have what you tried? For record or recording in this week? Do you want to share anything that you suggest? This is for the last week.
No, I don't know.
Okay, I actually discussed with a with one of my friends and
नहीं समझ आएगी क्योंकि उस वक्त रिकॉर्डिंग नहीं होती होगी
करेक्ट
कोई है या नहीं
इज देयर अ बेटर प्लेस यू कैन मूव टू
आपकी आवाज बहुत कट रही है वर्षा
बहुत ही
जी
टूट रही है हम आपकी मधुर आवाज सुनना चाहते हैं पर टूट इतनी रही है कि सिर्फ वो ऐसा कान में घंटियां सी बज रही हैं आपकी जो आवाज थोड़ी थोड़ी होके आ रही है ब्रेक होके
बोलेंगे
मुझे यहाँ फुल नेटवर्क बता रहा है
अभी
और मैं
अच्छी आ
कुछ
रही है
नहीं कर पा रही हूँ
नहीं नाउ इट्स गुड
नहीं नाउ
ये बीच बीच में से ही कट जा रही है एकदम
अभी जैसे बोली ना आपकी मुझे अच्छी आ रही है तब अच्छी आई
अच्छा ठीक ठीक है
सो नाउ इट्स गुड अब बोलो आप रिकॉर्डिंग के बारे में क्या बोल रही थी
नहीं मैं कह रही थी कि रिकॉर्डिंग उस वक्त होती नहीं थी तो इसका वर्ड है भी या नहीं नहीं समझ आ रहा जैसे इंग्लिश में जूठा का वर्ड नहीं हो सकता ऐसे इसमें शायद इसका नहीं हो सकता या होता होगा नहीं पता मुझे नहीं मिला
नहीं नहीं होता ना तभी तो हम नया शब्द बना रहे हैं हम देखो हमने वी हैड डिसाइडेड टू क्रिएट दैट वर्ड बिकॉज वी नो देर इज नो वर्ड फॉर रिकॉर्डिंग राइट सो व्हाट दैट इज व्हाट वी हैड डिसाइडेड सो आई केम अप विथ वन ऑफ द वर्ड्स आफ्टर डिस्कसिंग विद वन ऑफ माई फ्रेंड्स बट इफ यू वॉन्ट टू सजेस्ट समथिंग एल्स और सम इम्प्रूवमेंट्स टू इट प्लीज डू दैट सो दैट वी कैन फाइनलाइज दैट वर्ड And once we know that, once we agree that this is a suitable word for recording, we will actually publish it. So, Varsha ji is an expert of making posters. So, we can have a single, just that new word with an example. We will try to create a poster. So, I can help you with that once we finalize it. So whenever we discover a new word, we will do that. We will make a poster, then publish it on our Twitter, Facebook, wherever we want, or share it with our friends, right? And add it to that sheet also, which Naveen ji was mentioning last time. Naveen Mahoday, your sheet.
I have it. I did not get a chance to send it, but can I share it on the screen? Can I show it to you after when the before the class ends?
Yeah, we can do that. Okay. So what does anybody remember what I came up with? I have used it in this last week at least twice on the group. And this, the first time I write it, I will actually break it so that you understand what different words it is made up of. So, bhautik madhyame is saptami. Because you want to say on or in. Bhautik madhyame. Jnana sanrakshanam. So these are the four words it combines to make the that thing bhautik madhyame jnana sanrakshanam now tell me if you want to improve something on this
to ye to bahut bada ho gaya lamba ho lamba sa ho gaya na
That would happen. So even if you think of this Lauh Path Gamini for use for trains, rail gadi. So it's the same thing. Wherever you don't have an original word, for example, even rail gadi in Hindi is a combination of two separate words, rail and gadi. right? So it's okay. It's, nothing is disallowed in the language as long as it is agreed between people, and then we start making it means public known to others. It works.
So jnana rakshanam,
sanrakshanam or rakshanam, yeah, anything.
Yeah, jnana rakshanam. अच्छा है मगर उत्तमम मगर ज्ञान
सी फॉर इंफॉर्मेशन और डेटा
ज्ञान इट्स नॉट ऑलवेज ज्ञान दैट इज रिकॉर्डेड राइट सो
नॉर्मली इट इज इन रियल टर्म्स यू वुड वांट टू यूज डेटा और इंफॉर्मेशन देयर सम फॉर डेटा और इंफॉर्मेशन आई एम जस्ट एडिंग कन्वर्टिंग इट टू नॉलेज to insist upon the fact that what you really want to record is has to be useful. So then it is knowledge. You don't want to record garbage. So data or information, think of a word for that as well. I am okay with that. So that is something that I myself did. That instead of thinking of a data or information word, I directly made it knowledge. Because think of a practical purpose. I want to keep some recording in on my computer or on my phone if it is useful, which means it is not garbage.
So Manoranjan के लिए रिकॉर्ड करने का वो ज्ञान में आता है क्या जो भी मनोरंजन के लिए रिकॉर्ड करते हैं
सो
ज्ञान के विभाग में
लेट अस ट्राई टू यूज इट सो लेट्स से मूवी रिकॉर्डिंग सो हाउ विल यू यूज दिस वर्ड विथ मूवी रिकॉर्डिंग सो चलचित्र so instead of gyan you will say bhautik madhyame chalachitra sanrakshanam so that is a movie recording
chalachitra sanrakshanam okay
so we okay. keep replacing this word with what we
this
want
word
to
with
right so let us write that actually we are really improving right here
is it chalachitra or chalanachitra
Chalachitra is a word in Hindi that I know. So chalachitra, can somebody confirm if I think it should be the same in Sanskrit also.
Chalachitra ka fir chalachitram ho jayega shayad.
Chalachitram.
Chalachitram.
So bhautik madhyame. Then so we can qualify it even better. Chalachitrasya sanrakshanam. So then it is more accurate.
Chalachitrasya sanrakshanam.
Oh, what happened? Sanrakshanam. Sometimes overwriting is easier than editing and then writing. So now same thing if you want to say a song recording geet so then it is geet sanrakshanam or just say geet sanrakshanam because in Sanskrit you don't have
to avashyak pehle ke do pad bhautik madhya mein avashyak hai क्या इज इट नॉट ऑटोमेटिकली अंडरस्टूड गीत गीत संरक्षणम इज
सेविंग द साउंड समवेयर
या गीत संरक्षणम इट्स शॉर्ट एंड इजी टू फॉर न्यू लर्नर्स इट्स इजी टू
करेक्ट
अंडरस्टैंड दैट इट्स रिकॉर्डिंग गीत संरक्षण
राइट या दैट इज एक्चुअली बेटर That bhautik madhyame is for somebody who really wants to know where is it means एक्सपेंडेड वर्ड, बट गीत संरक्षणम और ज्ञान संरक्षणम और चलचित्र संरक्षणम शुड बी गुड इनफ. सो डज एवरीबडी अग्री टू दिस?
आचार्य.
I have a question, Acharya Mahode.
Prachatu, prachatu.
We are saying bhautika sanrakshanam, so which is physical recording, right? Something like a tape. If I go by the exact meaning of the word bhautik, is something which is tangible or physical.
And so madhyama is medium. So physical medium, on the physical medium, you are saving something.
Yeah, but then if we say digital, which is actually like...
Digital is also video on a
physical. So, that is also bhautik madhyam, right? If I am not wrong.
Correct.
Yeah.
Digital is also somewhere physically recorded, right? Whether it is your phone or hard disk or wherever it is still a physical device.
Okay.
And even if you want to say mastishke jnana sanrakshanam, so recording in your brain, it is still there. You can just say mastishke because you don't have to say physical mastishk because it is understood that it is physical.
Okay,
Acharya. So, yeah, what Naveen ji also suggested is useful, that you can just say Chalchitra Sanrakshanam or Geet Sanrakshanam or Jnana Sanrakshanam. That should be enough. Bhautik Madhyam is understood, that you are making sure that the Sanrakshanam happens on a physical medium. Okay, so Varsha ji, now you have a project.
Okay,
these three words we can discuss it if you want to, but this Jnana Sanrakshanam, Chalchitra Sanrakshanam and Geeta Sanrakshanam, we will try to make a single poster out of it, just saying the meaning of each word. One is information recording, then movie recording and song recording, and we will make one example statement or out of it.
So we can make each poster for each word, one poster for each word.
Yeah, you can choose what, how you want to do it. Yeah, that is fine.
अगली बार अगर हमारे पास दो वर्ड हुआ तो एक तीन का पोस्टर एक दो का पोस्टर ऐसा उसे जो एक एक का एक बन सकता है ना.
Yeah, that's better actually. So one poster for each word, that will be nice. So everybody will get to see Varsha ji's art as well. So namo namaha Varsha ji. Namo Namah, Naveen ji. So Naveen Mahoday came with two separate names last time. You have your Telugu name also and one Naveen.
Is it showing both now?
Now, not now, but last
time. Okay. I disconnected from my mobile and joined from my desktop, so that's why. Okay. Was showing, yeah.
Okay. All right. I don't know if Hemantji knows to come back in. Okay, so let me share the screen once more. Okay, so everybody will get to see Varsha ji's art as well. She is a real nice illustrator, and we will keep discovering new words as we go along, keep inventing new words, not discovering necessarily. And if something already exists, just let everybody know. And this is also common what we did recently about Vyapari. So sometimes when you know the word in your own language, which is closed, which is also taken from Sanskrit, so you can, it is okay to use even the word Vyapari in Sanskrit, but the real word would be Vanika. So if you cannot think of anything, you can still say Aham Vyapari and it is okay. Because Sanskrit is one of the, not one of the, it is the richest language in the world. So it, the number of words you can imagine in Sanskrit does not match with any other language. Right? So depending on the need, Sanskrit speaking people can create your own words. So it is always useful. So even if somebody is learning,
suggest any Hindi to Sanskrit dictionary. Do you have any reference that we can get one? Hindi to Sanskrit, English to Sanskrit, anything. If you have any reference.
Hindi to Sanskrit. I don't remember the name, but I have one at home. I will take a picture and try to send it on the group. Let me take that as my graha karya. But today what happens is whatever you want to look for, it is so available on the internet so fast that it's rare that you open up a dictionary. But on the internet, sometimes it may happen that the information is not always accurate unless you trust the source. All right, so from internet,
typically that was the question that I'm asking, because I tried to find some words in the last class itself, and then there were actually very bad words, frankly speaking.
For which one?
I don't recollect. Maine kaun sa shabd dekha tha mujhe nahi yaad hai, but wo नहीं थे सही. वो देखकर समझ में आ रहा था कि वो जबरदस्ती का ट्रांसलेट किया गया था, मतलब उसका कोई बेस नहीं था.
Okay.
या हिंदी के शब्द को कर दिया गया था ऐसे ही.
राइट, एंड इट इज गुड टू हैव अ डिक्शनरी डेफिनेटली, बिकॉज़ व्हेन समबडी सेज और राइट्स अ रॉन्ग वर्ड, यू कैन करेक्ट एज वेल व्हेन यू नो द राइट थिंग. ऑलराइट, सो या आई विल शेयर the image of that one. And
Acharya Mahoday.
Yes, Mavinji.
Dictionary padam Sanskritasya kim.
Oh, nice. Shabdakosh.
Shabdakosh. Okay.
So Shabdakosham. Or
Shabdakosha,
depending on
Shabdakosha. Okay.
So now you will notice that even this is actually a combination of two words.
Okay.
Right? Shabd and Kosha.
Shabd and Kosha.
So Kosha is Khazana.
So in Telugu, it is Nighantu. I don't know if that origin from Sanskrit or not, but it's called Nighantavu in Telugu. Now, of late, I'm realizing that there's quite a bit of influence of Urdu in Hindi, and there's also some influence of Urdu in Telugu. other regional languages also.
Even Telugu has some?
Yeah, even Telugu, there is some influence of Urdu. Yeah.
Okay.
In Hindi, there is influence because Hindi नाम ही वो हिंदवी, उर्दू को हिंदवी या हिंदी कहा जाता था.
हाँ.
बाद में वो उर्दू अलग हो गया और फिर हिंदी अलग हो गया. पहले संस्कृत ही यूज होता था, उसके बाद अरे तो बहुत सारी बोलियां थी, ब्रज.
हाँ.
और ठेठी, अवधी, ये सारी थी.
करेक्ट, एंड फॉर मेनी ऑफ द वर्ड्स यू विल ऑलवेज फाइंड अ संस्कृत इक्विवेलेंट. So even if you use, for example, guzarish in common language, to make a request, but you actually have a real word for request, which is prarthana in Sanskrit or even Hindi.
Yachana.
Yachana or prarthana, and yachak or prarthi, depending on if you are using it as an adjective, then you can use that. So we will always find a Sanskrit equivalent, and if we don't, we will create that. So that is a project for every Sanskrit learner or any language learner. When you don't find an equivalent, create something for the correct use of that expression. So we'll do that. So our first few words are out. All right. So now I, as the last thing to discuss today, we will do this next time because these are too many words. But what I wanted to show you is some common misuses. We may not be able to cover all, but let's try a few. So it's not always a misuse because as I said, there is a variety of things. So let me tell you a few things first. Do you know what does this mean?
Matlab pakshi chudiya.
Right?
Chidiya.
Khaga.
Khaga. Chidiya.
Bird. Now, in Sanskrit, you will find another word, vihagaha, which is also used for birds.
Vihagaha.
Oh. So it also varies by who is writing. So some people prefer to write khaga in, or and sometimes some people consider vihagaha as more literary Sanskrit. So literary means, for example, when Valmiki ji is writing like the Ramayana level Sanskrit, then he would use vihagaha. But for a Sanskrit learner, it's just good to know, because you might find vihagaha also, khagaha also, in different books or different texts.
Hindi ke paryayvachi mein humne vihang padha tha shayad. Vihang.
Yes, Varsha
ji. Vihang is a different word. Vihang does not mean birds. So vihang has a different meaning. So right now I won't. They are synonyms. They are paryayvachi.
Okay.
Now you will also realize that there are other words for specific birds. So now when we talk about, let's say, shukah. Correct. So, and this is interesting to learn, that you have a common word for all birds and all birds, which is khagaha or vihagaha. Now tell me, what is this shukaha?
Ye tota.
Parrot. Okay. Shukaha.
Correct. Let us try to make one.
Meri nana ji ka naam tha Shukdev, isliye pata hai.
Oh.
Oh, Varsha ji, where are you from?
I am from Bihar.
Oh.
Uttama.
Now does this look...
red word green.
Now does this look like a parrot? I am going trying to erase that red boundary also. I should have drawn with green itself, but now
that's unique parrot.
Now that
sure none of us will be able to draw one so quickly. The quickest is what you can draw.
I have to, because I have to explain, right? So I am used to drawing all the time. I am into,
and I hope everybody has seen Acharya's DP.
Yes.
Oh, I have to improvise that. Because, yeah, I drew that on the day of this Ayodhya Pujan. But now one of my friends pointed out that it is more looking like a masjid than a mandir. So now I have to make another painting where it looks more like a temple than something else. So, but it's okay for now. We can.
गुंबद के जगह हमारे में नुकीला वो होता है structure ज़्यादा होता
है. So it's more like this.
Yeah.
Then you have the. Now you can immediately imagine that I am making a temple.
Yeah.
Right. So this is what I am going Shikhar. To make.
Yeah. Shikhar.
See, फिर गलती हो गई. हरे हरा मंदिर बन गया.
अरे okay, let us just try to keep the beautiful colors away from too much of classification, because otherwise we will never be able to use green anyway.
नहीं नहीं मंदिर generally हमारा लाल होता है.
हाँ brownish yeah that mud color.
Okay.
Okay, so what I will say now, let us create something more. Now tell me, what is this?
Coil. Coil.
Correct.
Nahin.
Correct, correct. Cuckoo.
Coil.
Oh,
right, so pikaha is cuckoo or koel. Now this one is very easy. This is because it is in the name itself.
Madhura.
Mayuraha.
Mayuraha.
Is it looking like a
No.
Okay, let me try to create that one as well. I don't know if how nice it will be, but let's see. Now I can fill a little more. Of this one. Now it should definitely look like one.
Perfect.
Okay. No, drawing helps because when you see things more than just writing, it will help us retain more. So you will remember for a longer time. So even if you are holding a pen or a pencil somewhere, try to draw. Even if you just draw one bird, that is also enough. But when you represent what you learn with drawing, you will remember it more. All right, so okay, now
so
yes Naveenji,
I mean, like, let me know when you want me to share those words, Acharya Mahoday.
Oh, okay, yes, so let us do that right now. We are done with today's class, so you can share. Let me make you a presenter. I think then you will have to share. Do you see a presentation option? Yeah, I think you are already one.
Can you see it?
Yes. You are starting to share. It shows that you are starting to share. Okay, nice. Yes, we can see it now.
Yeah.
So may, there might be certain vibhakti errors, so bear with me.
Okay.
So there is adamant, right, in English?
Yes.
So that is, I think there is an equivalent for that in Sanskritam called adaman or adaman.
Okay, adaman.
Adaman, huh.
Hmm.
And attic, there is ataka.
Atak, okay.
Ataka, huh. And attraction is like akarshan in Hindi and akarshana in Sanskritam.
Correct.
And avatar, is, you all know about avatar. And axis is aksa and aksha in Sanskritam.
Hmm.
And this is bandit, and in Telugu there is a similar word, bandhu. And bangle, now, yeah.
Okay. Aksha has another meaning in Sanskrit, and we can discuss okay. that next time. Aksha means the tears, asu. That
oh,
is
Aksha.
Is Rudra.
But does it also, is it also used for axis or no?
Aksha no, is used. Aksha is
used. Maths mein hum logo ne kiya tha.
Kya Varsha ji, aap?
You were saying something.
Main keh rahi thi, maths mein humne wo aksha kiya
hai. Aksha is axis also, okay. correct.
X, okay,
okay. Axis also and... Ashru.
And then bangle is it bangri in Hindi?
In Hindi we say chudi.
Chudi, okay.
Goriya kalaiya,
bala
de mujhe hari chudiya.
Okay. So bargain, again there is bairam in Telugu, it's similar. Bazaar you all know. And I think better, there is behtar, right? Yeah, that is Urdu, yeah. And bond is banda or bandham in Sanskritam. Brother is brother.
Bratra.
Sent, and sent is shat.
Shat,
right? Yes. And then character, charitriya, that's what?
Charitram.
And then chest, I don't know, in Sanskritam, is it called chati?
No, chati is in Hindi.
Vaksha, okay. Vaksha. And then this is chit.
So
I don't know.
This is nice. You can share the sheet, and if you
yeah.
can probably let us add to it. So whoever is aware of something, we can add. So.
हाँ मुझे अभी भी याद है जैसे त्रासदी हम बोलते हैं वो tragedy होता है in English.
Trasidhi.
Which one?
Tragedy and trasidhi.
Oh, tragedy is what is the equivalent for it?
Trasidhi.
Trasudhi.
Trasadhi.
Sadhi.
Trasadhi. Okay. I'll just add it here.
So we can start adding to this sheet.
Yeah, I'll share this. You can go through this, and if you find any contradiction or incorrect information, you can let me know. Or if you want to add new ones, you can add. You can directly add to the sheet.
That's fine.
I have only locked this main sheet, the other sheet ongoing. This is open for edit, so you can edit and make your comments also here.
you can make one more column where you can actually write in Lipi.
Okay. Okay. Original language Lipi. Okay. Okay.
So mainly for Sanskrit, we can have that column.
Yeah. Okay. I'll just say Sanskrit.
That is basically Devanagari.
Oh. Devanagari.
Yeah. I'll just say Devanagari then. It should be easy.
No, but even see, Devanagari is many languages. So you can still say Sanskritam and Devanagari in bracket is better. So that we know that okay. We will all write only in Sanskrit there. Because even Hindi uses Devanagari. Marathi uses Devanagari. So there.
Okay.
All right. Perfect.
Okay. Okay. Dhanyavadaha.
सर्वेषां नमो नमः शुभरात्रिः शुभदिनं
सर्वेषां नमो नमः शुभरात्रिः
नमो नमः
शुभरात्रिः नमो नमः
पुनर्मिलामः
आम
आम आम अवश्य
धन्यवाद.